On this episode of the Fab Forms, the Bibbster makes it to the point of no return. Today, I think I'm going to be cleaning the shop some. Been working on the gray car, taking some measurements, got to order some parts for that thing. But I felt like, maybe it's time to take this thing apart. If you don't know what this thing is, it's the Bibbster. It's going to be the Bibbster. Right now, it's just a Fox Buggy Mustang. I had started this project a while back, or I basically alluded to this project a while back. Basically, what's going to happen is I'm going to take this car, I'm going to cut it up, make an old school looking hot rod. I don't know, it may not even look like an old school hot rod. This may be some kind of wicked looking Mad Max looking thing when it's done. But anyway, that's the story on this. I'm not ready to really start it yet. I want to get the gray car done first. But I need some room in the shop, and I felt like maybe if I dismantled it and maybe cut it up a little bit, I can make some room. So it's the plan for today.
You gotta know what you wanna do. You gotta dedicate yourself to it. You gotta wake up thinking about it. Go to work thinking about it. Go to bed thinking about it. You gotta dream about it. I put my life on this. Hand to God. Other hand on my chest. I like these odds. I don't play by the rules.
No one does.
I butter both sides of my toast, low pump, just because.
You chase the golden arrow and watch the archers mark up in the sky. Don't think these simple favors will let you backtrack straight to simple times.
You gotta know, like you know gravity, that this is what's gonna happen in your life. First it's a dream, then you take action.
Getting closer, definitely lighter, but it ain't light enough. Basically what's gonna happen is I'm gonna cut this thing off the firewall. When I go back, I'm gonna do everything tube chassis, and the K-member, and the strut tower, and all that stuff's gonna be moved forward about a foot. I'll probably do all custom mounts for that, all the custom, you know, all the mounting points will be the same, but they'll be all custom mounts, and so I won't use any of the factory stuff. I'll hang on to it for right now, but it's not going to stay in its current form for sure. So, probably going to cut it off the firewall and then remove the hatch, and going to cut the back off right behind the doors. So, definitely going to shorten it up for sure.
What
you think it weighs? You ever picked up a car before?
No.
Saying it's easy.
You gotta work for this. You gotta be persistent.
It's going down. It's going down. We're cutting this thing up.
But why shouldn't it be that way? If your life's gonna be better than everybody else's.
Alright guys, that's it for this week. Hope you enjoyed it. The Bibbster, it's on its way. Gonna work on the gray car, try to get it finished, then back on this thing. I'm excited about the Bibbster. I can kind of get a vision for it now. So, want to touch on one little thing. I know that a lot of people are gonna comment and say, man, you ruined a good car. You know, that was a decent Mustang and you cut it up. You ruined it. You could have done this or you could have done that. And that brings me to the point of this video. Sometimes you have to be willing to be a zero before you can be a hero. Meaning, sometimes you just have to take risk in order to do big things, right? You have to be willing to take those risks in order to do big things, like cutting up a Mustang. So I'm taking the risk of cutting up this Mustang and it being just junk to try to do something good out of it, right? Try to make something different. And so if you're not willing to take risk, you're never gonna kind of step out of that norm and you're not gonna step out of what most people do. So, like I said, you gotta be willing to be a zero in order to be a hero. Take a little risk. Might get what you want out of life. That's it for this week. See you guys Friday.